Ok. Hello everybody. Today I would like to introduce a new Eclipse photo feature called coal mining. At first, I introduce to me. I am Angelo Zer. I am working at Saudi France Company. I am an enthusiasm Java developer, and I have done several contributions for Eclipse, like CSS engine, WTP JSON editor, code mining, and TextMate for Eclipse, and my current contribution is Minimap. I have created other Eclipse plugins like AngularJS Eclipse based on Tern IDE and Angular Eclipse based on TypeScript IDE. So, a plan with my talk. The first part I will speak about inline annotation. The second part, I will speak about coal mining, and at the end, I will show you a demo with GDT coal mining. GDT coal mining is a coal mining in Java editor. So, what is inline annotation? The inline annotation is an annotation which takes care of placing the necessary C space vertically or horizontally in the stylet text widget. It exists two kinds of inline annotation, line header annotation and line content annotation. So you can see in the screenshot, line header annotation with OK and error status. So you can see that it takes this annotation is drawn before the line. And you can see a colorized square, which is line content annotation. This annotation takes place in the line content of the line. With inline annotation, you can draw anything. You can draw text, graphics, image, and inline annotation are clickable. So you can bind custom action to do anything. So just a quick overview with inline annotation API. You have two classes, line header annotation and line content annotation, which are managed with inline annotation support, which works with a source viewer, an annotation painter. If you don't know annotation painter, it is used to highlight error in an editor. And please note that this support doesn't take care of performance for the content of inline annotation. So if you inline annotation, must compute some job, some work, and it takes time, your editor will freeze. And there are two main inline annotation support methods: find existing annotation and update annotation. So to show you inline annotation in action, I propose you to run a simple main demo with emoji. So the basic idea of this demo is to type some emoji tag name, and before this tag name, you draw a Unicode of the emoji. So you can type phone emoji, and you will see that Unicode of the emoji is drawn before the tag name, and it's this Unicode is a line content annotation, and you can see the total of emoji of the line. This inline annotation is a line header annotation. So after, you can type umbrella and earth, and display the Unicode and the total. In platform text example, you have another demo which is called inline annotation demo. This demo is interesting because you can see other features of the inline annotation. So you can type color, And after you must type RGB declaration. Here you can see line header annotation, which is error because your RGB declaration is wrong. You type RGB and you can see four line content annotation, each for parameter name. Red, green, blue are line content annotation, and this colored square is another line content annotation, but instead of drawing text, you draw a graphic. If you change the value of RGB, it updates the color. And the interesting of this demo is that you can bind a custom action. So you can click on this line content annotation, it opens a color picker, you choose your color, and it updates the RGB declaration. So this sample is helpful for CSS editor, for instance. So now I have I show you in action inline annotation. Now I would like to introduce code mining. So what is code mining? The idea comes from Microsoft Codelance, which is integrated in Visual Studio and Visual Studio Code. The idea is to draw non-editable information in the editor to help developer, like give an overview of the code, like show references, implementation of classes, method, provide some action like run, debug in before the Java main method or before the GUnit method, show some status like GUnit status. And the big point which is very important with code mining is that it don't freeze your editor. So when you type some content in your editor, it never freezes your editor. So what is different with inline annotation support? The first thing is that you manage mining instance instead of annotation. So you work with line header code mining, line content code mining. Code mining support use the inline annotation support, and as I said you, it don't freeze the editor. Or with two strategies. The first strategy is that code mining instances are created in background, and the first strategy is that draw of code mining is done only when content is ready. We will see that in next demo. So just to clarify what is annotation, what is mining, you can see that you have code mining line header annotation, which is private class, which aggregate several line header code mining. And you have the same thing for line content annotation. Just a quick overview of the code mining API. So you have a code mining interface which implemented with a line header code mining, a line content code mining. You have a code mining provider. This provider, the goal of this provider is to create a list of mining of your editor. You have a source viewer extension 5, which is used to manage mining, like register your code mining provider, update your mining. And the code mining API use the Java 8 compatible feature to create list of mining and to draw the mining when it is ready. So you have several methods for the mining, like set label to set a content of mining, draw method to draw. By default, it draw text, but you can draw anything like graphics. And get action to bind some custom action when you click in the mining. Code mining provider interface. So you have a provide code mining method, which return a completable future of list of code mining. And you have in the parameter of the viewer, which is used to extract some data of your editor, and the monitor. The monitor is very important to check the console of the monitor each time you create mining to stop quickly the creation of mining, because this provide code mining is called every time you are typing in the editor. And there is a source viewer extension 5. So the two interesting methods are set code mining provider to register your code mining provider, and update code mining, which is used to update mining. So now I would like to show you in action the same emoji demo, but with code mining. But before, I would like just to see the problem with performance. So this method is used to get the Unicode from the tag name of emoji. So it's fast, but we can emulate it to take some time. So it takes 1 second to retrieve the Unicode from the tag name. So let's start the demo with inline annotation. So the first thing is that it takes 3 seconds because we have three emoji, and if you type, you must wait 3 seconds before the stylet text is refreshed. So it's not usable. To resolve that, we have code mining. So I start the same demo, but with code mining, and you will see different behavior. The first thing is that you can see that the editor display quickly the text without Unicode. I will start it. You can see. So there are no Unicode, and each time code mining is ready, it displays the Unicode. So if I wait 1 second, after the Unicode is displayed. So after you can type text and it doesn't freeze your editor. In platform text, you have a sample code mining demo, which is too interesting. So you have a class A, and it shows the references. So you have two new A, you have two references. If you type new A, you have three references. And the second point is that you can type class name with a number. The number is used to emulate the time which references is computed. So if I type 2, we must wait 2 seconds to resolve 1, 2, and after the references is updated. So you can see that editor doesn't freeze. So now I would like to show you how to integrate code mining in editor, in your custom editor or with a generic editor. There are three steps to integrate code mining in your editor. The first is implement a code mining provider, like we have done with Emoji. The second is to register your code mining provider with code mining provider's extension point. And the last step is to update code mining when text change. So you can do that with Thread Reconciler. It exists code mining reconciler if you wish to use. But for instance, with GDT, we use a e-reconciling listener to update code mining, because this listener is fire when the compilation unit, the IST of the Java code, is ready. So we will see in the demo of GDT code mining, we must create code mining, like references, classes, method, only when compilation unit is ready. So we use e-reconciling listener to do that. So we will do this emoji editor. No, the first step is implement your code mining provider. So here is the code of code mining provider. The basic idea is to return a computable future, and inside this computable future, create a mining list and populate this mining list. As you can see, I call monitor is cancel as soon as possible to stop the creation of code mining to have a good performance. And after, I create emoji line content code mining instance, and I populate the mining. The mining list. So the emoji line content code mining wait the tag name and the position. Here I have not searched the Unicode from the tag name. Here the emoji line content code mining, it's the mining used for the emoji. So you can, the basic idea is to update the label, but when? If the Unicode, the search of Unicode of emoji is fast, you can do that in the constructor. But if the search of Unicode takes time, you must do that in a do resolve method, which this do resolve method return a computable future and update the label in async mode. The second step is to register your code mining provider in an extension with extension point. So the base, it's not very it's easy. So you declare just your code mining provider, and you declare enable one. In your case, you wish to display emoji mining only with emoji content type. You don't want display emoji in your Java editor, for instance. But if you want to display emoji in your Java editor, you can, and just adapt the enable when. And the last step is to update code mining. In custom editor, you can override the get reconciler from source viewer configuration and use code mining reconciler. Sorry. With generic editor, it's the same thing, but you do that with extension point. You can use the reconciler generic editor extension point, and you bind it with the emoji content type. So just to I will do that if I have time. So conmining is used in a real use case in a several projects, language server protocol for Eclipse, for Codelands support. You can see Spring Tools for language server in action, and color support. It's an experimental feature for CSS language server. Xtext integrates conmining too, and GDT conmining. So now I would like to see in action GDT conmining. GDT conmining is a project that I have created in my GitHub, and if it's mature, I hope that the GDT team will host my work. So at first, the GDT conmining provide a new Java editor conmining preferences, and you can see the whole mining managed with the Java editor. So we create a basic place. Okay, and you can enable show references. So you can see that this class has zero reference. You type some content, the main method has zero reference. So now class A has two references. And it doesn't freeze the editor. And you can click on to launch the search. Here you have a zero reference, which can be annoying. So you can remove it and show only if there are at least one reference. After, you have show method parameter names. So if you have a method like this, you can see the parameter name of your method. Okay. Now you can show run or debug for main method. So it's so you can run easily your main method. You can debug it too. You have to show variable values inline while debugging. So you can see variable value while debugging. So if I set a breakpoint here, you can see the value of my x here, which is 10. And after, if you increment it, you can see that mining refreshed the new Yalu. It's helpful when you have a complex algorithm to debug your code. After you have show end statement, so for instance, if you have this case, you can see the statement. So if you have a lot of statements, it's more comfortable to see the end statement, and you can click it and go when statement is declared. So now after you have GUnit code mining, statue run debug mining. So we create basic test. And you have you can see the statue of the test. The state is not executed. You can run the test, debug the test, and do the same thing for the all test of your class with run all or debug all. So if I run the test, you can see the statue of test has changed. If I fail the test, you can see that the test failed. So it's when you have a lot of tests, you can see where you test inside your editor which test has failed, which test has succeeded. And the last code mining is for Git. So you can show the last revision, last change, and show author who have contributed to the code. So, for instance, if I take a big file, stilled text, so you can see the references, but you can see that the last change, so it's me who have changed the stilled class 7 weeks ago, and there are 22 authors who have contributed to this class, and you have the same thing for method. And this stilled text sample is interesting because you have a lot of mining, and you can see that the editor doesn't freeze, so you can type anything it should not freeze. So I have finished with my GTT demo. I hope you like it. I hope too that you want to know if you have a custom text editor. I hope you want to integrate code mining. Nevertheless, there are some some bugs with the con mining. For instance, with Mac OS, the renderer is bad. So, but the issue is known, and there are some people who are search a fix. So, if you want if you want to play with con mining and you find problem or you wish to have some improvement, please create an issue in Eclipse Bugzilla in platform text or platform SWT with a con mining tag. If you wish to have some improvement or find bugs with GTT Java con mining, please create an issue in a GTT con mining project. There are some improvements for con mining. For instance, you can see if I select the parameter, it selects to the mining. The reason is because we use a glyph matrix with a stylet text, and glyph matrix replace the character where glyph matrix is done, and we redraw the character. You can see if I select, we can see that we draw that, and this character is redone. So you cannot select it. It's a little annoying, but I have created an issue for that. We must it's a little difficult because we must update text layout operating system. But yeah, for the moment we have done that. So I hope we will improve it. And at the end, I would like do a big thanks to several body who helped me to design con mining, to give me feedback, and test con mining as a list of the people. So I have just to finish. I have implemented con mining in platform text just for fun, and I have learned a lot to work with Eclipse guys. So many thanks to Eclipse guys. Have you any question? Thank you.
Do you plan, I've noticed, for GUnit, do you plan for test engine animations or not?
To be honest with you, I have created con mining at first for me, and after I had some feedback. Like Lars with Lars Vogel, and I have improved con mining. So if you want to have some new other con mining feature, please create issues, and if I have time, I will try to implement it.
So it would be in the test engine specifically implement the support for test engine application. So it would be another code mining provider in the test engine. Yes.
So what would be part of the Photon?
For Photon?
For the end user.
For end user, yeah. For end user, you will see just for Eclipse Photon. You will see nothing, but yeah, LSP4E and X text, yeah, and if you want, you can install my GTT con mining, but yeah, for the moment it's GTT was a little scared with con mining because we are not sure that con mining was not mature. And so my idea was to create a GDT con mining, have feedback from user, and after fix a con mining problem, and after when it will be mature, I will retry to contribute to GDT. But yeah.
But you can
okay.
And another one for the JUnit test, you said that usually con minings are related with a reconciler, which is when there is a text change. For JUnit, the event is not a text change, so you put JUnit is not.
Exactly, yeah. Yeah. So when your JUnit change, it updates the whole mining, but it's not very correct. We must improve the con mining API to update just the mining that you wish to update. So, but you know the problem with the API change. But yeah, I will create a. Okay. Thank you for listening.